Blackstone Publishing presents Just Desserts by Claudia Bishop. This book is read by Justine Eyre. For Natalie, with heartfelt thanks. Prologue.
Good weather for deer hunting.
Harland Peterson, his weather-beaten face ruddy with the satisfaction of being outdoors on a fine November afternoon, surveyed the sweep of rolling hills from his vantage point on the lip of Hemlock Gorge. The last of autumn's crimson tinged the maples. The sky was a blue a fellow could get lost in. The citizens of Hemlock Falls had been blessed with a slow, warm fall, and leaves still clung to the oaks and maples that grew thickly over the land near Hemlock Falls.
Good cover for deer.
Harlan's cousin, Petey, bristled.
I forgot more about deer than you ever knew. Them leaves ain't gonna make a damn bit of difference. And even if they do, the weather ain't gonna hold much longer. We're due for a big one. Says you. Says me. Huh, it was right on the TV this morning. Weather's not gonna hold till tomorrow, much less till Thanksgiving.
Like Harland, Petey had the bulbous Peterson nose and squared-off stubborn chin. He and Harland had opened hunting season together for 30 years. Every year, Harland seemed to forget that he, Petey, bagged his buck days before anyone else did, least of all Harland, who sometimes went the whole 2 weeks of the season without sighting a deer at all. Petey couldn't resist a jab back at Harland.
Course, you know all about the weather too, don't you, cousin? Deer and weather. Course the weather'll hold till Thanksgiving, Harland said.
He tugged the bill of his John Deere hat more firmly over his eyebrows and stuck his lower lip out in a stubborn way.
A lot of deer out there, too. More'n usual.
No, there ain't, Petey said.
All that new construction down by the river drove 'em off.
Their position on the north lip of the gorge gave them a panoramic view of Hemlock Falls and its environs. The village was at their backs. The copper roof and stone walls of the inn at Hemlock Falls sprawled across the gorge in front of them. And to the west, a mile or so down the Hemlock River, bulldozers and backhoes maneuvered over the construction site of the soon-to-be-completed Hemlock Falls Resort. A good quarter mile of woodland had been cleared from the dense trees at the edge of the river to make room for the new river marina and camping grounds.
Too many new people coming into town, Petey added glumly. Cutting down the trees, dumping their garbage, and I don't know what all. It's bound to affect the deer population. Fact. More people, more deer,
Harland said with the air of one who knew.
That's a fact. I was reading about it just the other day. Deer do better when the land's under cultivation. And what garbage are you talking about anyways?
Harland, who, along with other members of the Hemlock Falls Chamber of Commerce, had invested a not inconsiderable sum in the new resort, was sensitive to any nascent resentment of the newcomers.
There's no more garbage around here than there ever was. Any more garbage around there than there's been before, I'll go pick it up myself.
Petey jerked his thumb sideways.
Down there, in it. Where? I don't see a damn thing. And don't go making up stuff to blame the workers, Pete. Can't help it if you decided not to put cash into the resort. Ain't my fault you got the guts of an earthworm.
This last comment, delivered with some affection, didn't appear to ruffle Petey at all. In fact, he ignored it altogether and stared past Harland into the east side of the gorge. He rubbed his chin, a thoughtful glint in his eye.
You know why you never get your deer, Harland? You never get your deer because you can't see worth a bucket of warm spit. I tell you, I'm looking at garbage. You better believe I'm looking at garbage.
Harland squinted in the direction of Petey's gaze. He had, in fact, bowed to the inevitable and picked up a pair of magnifying glasses at the Walmart some days ago. He pulled them from the pocket of his red man coveralls and fitted them over his nose with care. The slope of woods Petey was pointing to came into focus. And Petey was right. There was a bundle of garbage insulting the landscape. Somebody had shoved a pile of old clothes and goodness knew what all right over the edge of the gorge.
Heck,
Harland said. Whatever it was going to get ripe. You could tell that even from here. A couple of crows had settled in the...
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.